Choi Pioneer School. Captain, I said Chu. First speaker, Shemaine. Second speaker, Katrina. Concluding speaker, Jeremy. On the left lip side, Good Hope Pioneer School, from kindergarten. Captain, Kimberly Jo. First speaker, Iris Cho.
Many children feel closer to their helpers than to their parents. This seriously affects parent-child relationships and who the children will model on. Many children spend most of their time with their helpers and have difficulty developing a trust in their own parents. Tsingtao Daily also points out that most parents expect the foreign domestic helpers to do everything for the children, leading to highly dependent children with little self-management skills. A self-centered attitude develops when children realize that the foreign domestic helper have no authority over them, and many kids have difficulty conforming to rules and instructions. With a ban, children are forced to help around the house and develop survival skills, such as cooking for oneself and a greater respect for those around them. For more independent and responsible children and closer family bonds, this motion has to stand. Thank you.
May I now invite the captain from the negative team to deliver his speech?
Chairperson, honorable judges, my learned opponents, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Today's motion is foreign domestic helpers should be banned in Hong Kong. I am the captain of the opposing team. Our team strongly disagrees with this motion. According to the statistic published by the Labor Department in December 2014, there were 330,000 foreign domestic helpers in Hong Kong, with the majority being female Filipino or Indonesian. The number accounts for 4% of our population. Debate number shows a huge demand. The demand is capable of showing that foreign domestic helpers play a very important role for many families, especially those with working parents. The demand is ever increasing. The great assistance in the household frees up workforce for family members and working mothers. With more people joining the workforce, more families can increase their household income for better quality of life. As a result, Hong Kong's economy and productivity benefit from the increased in talented or dedicated workers switching from home to work. But let me clarify one point here. The system of foreign domestic helpers does not only benefit Hong Kong households. In fact, working abroad as a household service worker has become an indispensable platform for these foreign workers coming from countries with higher unemployment rates, like Philippines and Indonesia, to earn more money to improve their living standards as well. The money Filipino or Indonesian make per month in Hong Kong is at least 4 to 6 times higher than they can make in their homeland. Our dear opponents, what kind of motivation can force hundreds of thousands of foreign workers to come here if what we can offer is nothing but misery? Please inspire us. It is crystal clear that the foreign domestic helper system is a win-win situation to both the foreign worker and the local employers. My first speaker will further elaborate on this. Our dear opponents must not ignore the impact on Hong Kong household if all these foreign domestic helpers are gone. Let's assume each of the 330,000 helpers work for one family. How many families will be affected if foreign domestic helpers is to be banned? Parents may be forced to give up their job to take care of the kids and the elderly. Some may say this isn't a bad outcome. Well, only for more prosperous families, when one of the parents can afford not to earn extra and stay home. The opportunity cost of not working is huge. And some may argue that we have local services in the market to replace foreign domestic helpers, such as local helpers, childcare center, and elderly home. However, the cost of these services are even higher. Not every family will be able to afford. My second speaker will further explain why the local market is indeed not as practical an alternative as one may wish it to be. In light of the great demand and benefits of having foreign domestic helpers, today's motion must fall. Thank you.
Good afternoon, debaters and adjudicators. Our opponents have attacked us by saying that there will be financial burden for families when all moms have to return home to take care of children. But but we believe that 2-year transitional period is enough time for government to provide better child care options and companies to improve family-friendly work arrangements like America and other European countries. Example, daycare, flex time, work-from-home arrangements. We have discussed the effects on Hong Kong children if foreign domestic helpers continue to work in Hong Kong. But what about the children in the home countries of foreign domestic helpers? Mothers leave the country to work, leaving their child with their full-time working dads. According to a study by the United Nations in 2008, children of foreign domestic helpers in the Philippines are more likely to score lower on academic tests, fall ill of common colds, and are more likely to suffer from loneliness and anxiety issues. We are supporting this system by encouraging mothers to leave their families and be trapped in an abusive system here in Hong Kong. We have all heard about Ariana Sulistiani C, who was physically abused for 8 months in Hong Kong. She slept on the floor, worked 21 hours a day, and was never permitted a day off. South China Morning Post found out that 58% of foreign domestic helpers have experienced verbal abuse, 18% physical abuse, and 6% sexual abuse, which is shocking. This problem is sadly not getting any better. The foreign domestic helper industry in Hong Kong should be stopped for their own safety, not to mention other reasons that we will discuss today. For the sake of all foreign domestic helpers, we believe this motion must stand. Thank you.
Time used 2 minutes and 5 seconds. No marks will be deducted. I now call upon the first speaker from the negative team to deliver the speech.
Good afternoon. First of all, I must clarify that household service workers are no different from any other workers. It is just another occupation we appreciate and respect. They work for the better life of their families, just like the rest of us. The system of foreign domestic helper has made positive impact on our economic growth. With the availability of impact on our economic growth of overseas household service workers, more family members can join the workforce. As a result, not only are these families able to generate more household income, but it also increases the productivity and thus contributes to economic growth in Hong Kong. Our team sees this as a win-win situation. It is because foreign domestic helpers also benefit from working in Hong Kong. If you don't believe me, listen to what the Philippines Consulate General of HKSAR said. They published a statement earlier this Tuesday which supports our belief that this system is nothing but a mutually beneficial one. This statement reads, they have left their loved ones back home to earn a decent living taking care of Hong Kong families. This in turn has engendered positive impact on both the quality of life of the families concerned as well as the economy of Hong Kong as a whole. The perception of Filipino government is of significant importance. It tells us no stakeholder, and not even government, sees the situation as domestic helpers being taken advantage of. Is there any driving force for hundreds of thousands of domestic helpers to leave home and work in Hong Kong if they think they are enslaved here? Is it true that there is nothing this place can offer but hardship and suffering? No! We believe, besides the attractive salary and comprehensive labor law for protection, Hong Kong also offers mutual support and appreciation. Therefore, today's motion must not stand. Thank you.
Time used 2 minutes and 4 seconds. No marks will be deducted. I thank the first speaker of the negative team for his speech. I now invite the second speaker from the positive team to deliver the speech.
Good afternoon, everyone. I want to have a practice by saying that without the required domestic helpers, it will slow down economic growth. But we believe this is not true, and we disagree. Because healthier ties between families also said without foreign domestic helpers, there won't be such good financial. But we think that it's not so. But there will be a two-year transitional period, which would be enough for the Filipino government to create more jobs for the foreign domestic helpers. Next, allow me to explain why domestic helpers must be banned. Domestic helpers cause devastating social impact when all 310,000 helpers relax and socialize on the streets. Imagine trying to go for a walk at Victoria Park or Central on a Sunday, only to have the peaceful atmosphere destroyed by inconsiderate and noisy helpers. Secondly, more helpers will mean more competition for local jobs. According to Paul Yip, a professor of social administration at the University of Hong Kong, due to the relatively low cost of hiring domestic helpers, the rate of locals are attractive to families who need help. Therefore, the arrival of foreign domestic helpers will mean that locals will have troubles finding a secure job. So why shouldn't we ban domestic helpers for the sake of Hong Kong's locals? On the other hand, can a poet explain why they think that money is more important than relationships with their parents and children? Thank you.
Time is 1 minute and 43 seconds. No points will be deducted. I thank the second speaker of the positive team for the speech. May I now invite the second speaker from the negative team to be able to speak.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Throughout this debate, our dear opponents have tried to tell you that the foreign domestic helper system in Hong Kong creates so many controversies that it should be banned. If you think banning it can put those problems to an end, perhaps you've missed the full picture. Our team firmly believes if foreign domestic helpers are banned, much inconvenience will be caused, and that is going to be our biggest challenge. Some may argue that by banning foreign domestic helpers, families who used to have foreign domestic helpers could switch to the local market for daytime helpers, childcare or elderly care facilities. The more common alternative for many families is to have a family member to quit his or her job, stay home, and take over household duties. These do sound like viable options, don't they? Well, if they were, the huge demand for foreign domestic helpers would be a puzzle. First, local services are more expensive. It is pointless to work when a large portion of the hard-earned money goes to hiring. Then what about childcare and elderly care facilities? The truth is, places are very limited. These facilities are unlikely to be able to deal with a sudden influx of children or aged persons when domestic helpers are banned. Our dear opponents may think that the government should take up the responsibility to provide more of childcare and elderly care facilities to support the rising demand. The government does have a role to play, but resources are limited. There's no way the government can offer guaranteed provisions of services to all working families. Even if there are public services, we don't see why our freedom to pick private services should be taken away. Banning foreign domestic helpers does not make the government look more responsible at all. To conclude, families hiring foreign domestic helpers are supported by practical considerations. Our team believes that the needs of Hong Kong families should not be ignored, and the system of foreign domestic cover deserves to be defended. Thank you.
2 minutes and 11 seconds. No points will be deducted. I thank the second speaker of the negative team for the speech. We now proceed to the free debate section of the debate. The positive side and the opposition will have 2 minutes of time to speak. Time will run on a cumulative basis for each side separately. Each speaker shall stand up before he or she begins to sit and sit down after finishing his or her speech. No speaker can stand up and speak for more than 2 consecutive times. The positive side shall begin first. One of its speakers on stage shall stand up and speak. Once the said speaker sits down, the clock will begin to run for the opposition. A speaker from the opposition shall stand up and respond immediately and shall sit down after he or she finishes. The positive side of the opposition shall speak in turn until one of the teams has used up the entire duration and time of time attributed to it. When the time has 30 seconds left, the bell will ring once. When one team has used up their speaking time, the bell will ring twice. The other side shall then send one of its team members to use up all the remaining duration of time. Is there any problem regarding the rules of free debate? If not, we are now invite speaker from the positive team to offer the free debate.
If you disagree with a ban on importing helpers, are you supporting that the government should shirk responsibility and providing more quality childcare?
Our dear opponent, what exactly is the link between government doing more for a Hong Kong household and the freedom to hire foreign domestic helpers? We don't see any relation between the two.
Indonesia and Myanmar have already banned exporting women working as foreign domestic helpers to preserve human dignity for the people. Hong Kong being an international city that supports human rights, shouldn't we take the lead in banning the import of foreign domestic helpers?
Do you ban all the cars because there were fatal car accidents?
With the wide availability of foreign domestic helpers, many children cannot even tie their shoelaces at the age of 11. Are supporting a reliant generation of Hong Kong kids?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is such a convenient blame. But your mother is the one who hired her. Shall we ban all caring moms because they make you reliant?
If you don't trust them, why should you even hire them? With our living policy, most foreign domestic helpers have to work over 15 hours with little privacy. Are you endorsing human exploitation?
We do have sufficient guidelines to ensure their working environment is of a reasonable standard. Employers will be subjected to penalty if they fail to comply. There's no cases all over twist here, my dear opponent.
Do you think making more money is more important than the relationship between parent and child?
If the parents truly want to have good relationship with their children, they would have bonded with their kids and made time to be with them.
If you disagree with the ban on importing helpers, are you supporting that the government should shirk responsibility in providing more quality child care?
Our dear opponent, what exactly is the link between government doing more for Hong Kong household and the freedom to hire foreign domestic helper? We don't see any relation between the two.
Do you think that making money is more important than the relationship between parent and child?
What about for single parent families? Who will be the one to quit the job and make a sacrifice? The only parent? Then who's the one to make money?
Well, parents can have a part-time job. And Indonesia and Myanmar have already banned exporting women and working as foreign domestic helpers to preserve human dignity for the people. Hong Kong being an international city that supports human rights, shouldn't we take the lead in banning the import of foreign domestic helpers?
The foreign domestic helper system is providing Hong Kong one of the greatest competitive advantages. If we ban the foreign domestic helpers in Hong Kong, how are we going to compete with Singapore, Malaysia, and many other countries?
If there are qualified English teachers at tutorial schools, why do we have to hire a domestic helper to teach your children English? Many families now hire domestic helpers just to teach their children English.
Thank you.
Yes, the amount of money, we are happy to know that they have other options to earn a decent living, but what does this have to do with banning domestic helpers?
Time is up for the negative team. I invite the positive team to go over the speech. May I invite the concluding speaker from the negative side to conclude the negative team's case?
Thank you.
2 minutes and 30 seconds. May I invite the concluding speaker from the positive side to conclude the positive teams.
Testing. Dear adjudicators, opponents, and classmates, today we see a clear winner, and the winner is side proposition. Let me first highlight some flaws of this debate. In US and Canada, there aren't any foreign domestic helpers to help the children, but Western countries do a great job in educating children because they have daycares, flex time, and work from home arrangements. And I believe that Hong Kong should follow. In fact, Aquino administration have already agreed to give more efforts on jobs creation at home rather than banking on sending overseas foreign workers. Firstly, our opponent's captain has said that only rich families can afford to only have one person working in the household, as the other one has to take care of the child and the elderly. But we don't agree. There could be a two-year transitional period, which will be enough time for the Hong Kong government to increase job opportunities. Secondly, our opponent's first speaker has said there will be no economic growth, but there will be stronger parent relationships and more independent children. Thirdly, our opponents have said that there will be limited places and resources, but side proposition doesn't agree. During the two-year transitional period, the government can build more places. On the other hand, our team has proven to you how a ban will benefit both the helpers and Hong Kong families. Our captain has shown you the dire problem of Hong Kong kids, and a ban of foreign domestic helpers will train our children to be more independent again. Our first speaker highlighted the inhumane treatment that the foreign domestic helpers face and problems at home when they work for us. A ban will stop such exploitation. Our second speaker has also shown you a foreign domestic helper ban will lower public congestion on holidays and improve job opportunities for local helpers. This is a side with foresight. We support better life for helpers and Hong Kong people alike. So this motion must and will stand. Thank you.
No points will be deducted. I thank the concluding speaker for the positive sign for the speech. Before we end the debate, may I now invite the adjudicators to deliver comments.
Have a break 5 minutes.
Now we will have 5 minutes break.